Movie reviewers hated the Rocky Horror Picture Show when it first flashed its fishnets over 40 years ago, but that hasn't stopped the film's millions of fans turning up at midnight screenings around the globe to watch the movie about a singing alien transvestite and his horde of eccentric followers. And Patricia Quinn actually played Magenta in both the original stage show and the film. And Angela Bishop caught up with her at the Hollywood show for this Australian exclusive.
Michael Rennie was ill the day the earth stood still, but he told us where we stand.
These are arguably the most famous lips in cinema history, and they belong to this woman, Patricia Quinn.
Science fiction.
The theatre-trained actress created Magenta in the original 1973 London production of the Rocky Horror Show.
We did it upstairs at the Royal Court Theatre, 60-seat theatre, and I said to my agent, what is this about, this Rocky Horror thing? He said, I don't know. He said, I think it's something about a circus. I said, all right. He wasn't wrong, because I've been in this circus ever since.
Science fiction.
Like the play, the film opened with the iconic science fiction, but Patricia almost turned down the celluloid version after learning someone else would sing the title song. Creator Richard O'Brien and the man who wrote it and played Riff Raff pinched your song in the movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I said, you mean I'm not singing science fiction? And they said, no. I said, oh, well, I'm sorry, I don't wish to do your film. Because the only reason I ever accepted it was to sing that song. And they said, well, no. And then John Goldstone, one of the producers, said, well, come round to my house, which is round the corner. And he said, we'd just like to show you the sets and the costumes. So I go around, look at the sets, and I see a pink laboratory, and I see things called Transylvanians that we didn't have in the show, and motorbikes and frocks that we didn't have. And I said, oh, I'm doing this.
It's so dreamy, oh, fantasy free me, so you can't see me. No, not at all.
Happy now.
Yes, I thought they were going to get Shirley Bassey to sing it, you know, like Goldfinger or something, you know.
Yeah.
Because they need a real voice or something. So we were in the car going down to the Bray Studios, Tim Curry, me in the middle, and Richard. And Tim said, by the way, Richard, who is singing science fiction? And Richard said, I am. I said, you bastard.
How dare you?
I wanted to kill him.
She may have lost the song, but the Aussie director had a plan in place for Pat to appear in the opening titles.
And Jim Sharman said, have you ever seen Man Ray's lips? I hadn't, so I didn't know what he was talking about. And he said, it's a disembodied mouth, and we thought we could have your mouth singing science fiction. Well, they had no special effects to do this. You know, this was an amazing idea. And I said, my mouth and his voice? How much? They blacked out my face completely and drew the lips. And then they put me on camera. But when you sing, you move. And the mouth kept going out of frame. And so they screwed my head in to the lamp thing.
God.
So I couldn't move.
Oh. How long
and
were you like that
time,
for?
Not very long, because I knew the song.
Oh, true.
Yes, quite. And anyway, at the time, my husband at the time kept ringing to talk to me about a divorce. I said, well, tell him I can't do anything about it. I'm clamped.
My head's in a vice. Busy right now.
No time for a divorce today.
How do you do, I? See, you've met my faithful hand in hand.
It's hard to imagine anyone but Tim Curry as Dr. Frankenfurter. But Mick Jagger was originally in the mix to play the cross-dressing alien. Steve Martin auditioned for the role as Brad, the part that went to Barry Bostwick.
Just what exactly are you implying?
But there was one larger and louder casting choice that surprised everyone.
Whatever happened to Saturday night? when you got the job and you felt alright.
So Meatloaf wanted to act, you know. Why? And he had a voice like that. So on the first day of rehearsal in London, suddenly in walks this guy whom I've never met, and this redneck Texan, and he hears me, ha, ha. God, who's that? And then he got up and sang Hot Patootie, and I just fell off my chair. I can't believe it.
I really like rock and roll. Hot Patootie, bless my soul.
That age, that voice, like it's the purity of it, because he was a gospel singer, that's where he began with all that. This was stunning.
It's astounding. Time is fleeting. And in the more than 40 years since it premiered, there is one song that is guaranteed to get everyone dancing.
It's just a jump to the left, and then a step to the right.
Put your hands on your hips.
The Time Warp became a global hit, even reaching number 3 on the Australian ARIA charts in 1980. Patricia's life became more colourful in 1995 when she became a lady after marrying Sir Robert Stevens. She quickly found that there are Rocky fans everywhere, even in the hallowed halls of Buckingham Palace. You're a lady.
I'm a lady.
You are a lady. And you've met Prince Charles, have you not?
Prince Charles made me a lady. Charles invited Robert and Pat to Sandringham, Queen Victoria's home, because he has a cultural weekend once a year, which is for painters, actors, poets, folk like that. So Charlie Boy said to me afterwards, a while after, he said, I'm so sorry I didn't see you, Pat, at the show. I couldn't really turn up in fishnets and garters.
Prince Charles said that?
Yes. But you could have come as Brad, the nerd, in Y France and a doctor's coat. And I thought,
Patricia, it's been a delight talking to you. Thank you so much for being part of this today.
Bless your
heart.
Really
happy to meet you.
Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you.
I want to come back to Australia.
Well, let's do it.
Yes.
She was brilliant.
I loved her. She's one of my favourite interviews ever, because every time I asked a question, you just never knew where it was going to go. And it was brilliant. So if you've got a hankering to see some more Rocky Horror now, the good news is the stage show is coming back again in December, and Craig McLaughlin will be putting on the tights one more time to be Dr. Frankenfurter. So it's December in Adelaide, then Brisbane, and then Perth. So look out for tickets for that.
From Dr. Fantastic. Blake to Dr. Frankenfurter.
Yes. We've also got to thank the Hollywood Show for access to that interview. That was so brilliant.